Well, good morning. It is 5:50 in the morning. We need to get going, yeah. Got a long day ahead of us. Bunch of stuff we gotta do. Some animals. So for our Mac, let's see if we can get them, yeah. This is Mac. Come, hello Sephora. And this is Sephora. Bouncing me over. Sephora is my pup. She's about a year and a half. Year and a half old. Female. And this is Mac.
Hey girl, do you feel that temperature drop? Let time burn tick tock. The whole world spinning then stop. Well, can you feel it? What about that breeze is blowing through? Pull me next to you.
These are my pointers. I got Sephora end of last year. So I can breed with her. I've had Mac for 6 years now. 6-7 years. Never bred with him. He comes from a great bloodline. Trying to get some pups out of them before he becomes too old. Something I've never dabbled in before. Took a long time for me to get a decent female to put with him. Jump right in to show you how it works. Good morning. Gonna fix this guy up. These rashes that he's got. Gonna sort him out quickly. Tell breeding ram this one. This is one of the younger ones.
Yeah, Dad and I are trying to apply some cream to infected area on the ram that picked up a rash. It's always a good idea to keep your infected animals in a quarantined area. I've also consulted with the vet. He has inspected the animal. And always a good tip, talk to your vet. He knows it all, even if it's just a quick phone call, just making sure that you are doing the right thing and that the situation is being handled correctly. The cream we are applying is mainly used in dairies for milking purposes, keeping the skin soft and moist. The main ingredient is landolin, acrovelvine, and mercurochrome. But always read your labels and make sure that what you're applying is the right thing, as well as, like I said, speak to your vet. We also spray a fly repellent over and on the sides of the ram so that the flies don't infect the wound area.
Okay, so we got the ram all cleaned up, got them all fixed up. I'm gonna send them out to the pasture now. Come. There we go. Okay, come. Ram's only 10 months old. That's the one that's... There's the skin nurse. Maybe we'll get better. No problem. So yeah. Breeding guy right there. Bad boy. So yeah. I'll show you around. This is some of the pasture blocks. I'll get a better photo here. I'm gonna show you guys what's going on here. Hey. 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 Hey, Blue. Hey. Hey, hey. Hey, hey.
Okay, so I'm gonna try and do this in short snippets here. It's a ram camp. Got everything labeled up. Ram camp, and it's just sleeping camp, sleeping camp. I'll show you the guys later on. There's another sleeping camp. Here's some more. Here's our workstation. Right here. Let me just walk over. Standing there. Rams. Kind of where we do all the work, all the grooming. This is our grooming stand. We do the horns, the hooves, shearing, etc. So, yeah, I'm gonna show you quickly, show you the birth camps where they sleep. Here's another camp. Here's where the small lambs, they got their own feed lot, if you want to call it that, feeding space, where the rams are, ram feeding space. Space. This is where we. It's getting to be a long video. So the gate here. Okay, so it needs to be baled. Here's some of the bales we just made. Kind of just cover them just for extra rain protection, even though there's a roof. So here's some shed. On the other side of that is our feeding shed. So there's a loading. So just get over here. Make sure that you want to sleep. Some of them, kind of split them at night just for safety purposes, and then they don't fight with one another. That's where they sleep at night. There's a birth camp. Birth camp. Oh my goodness. There we go. So, this is where you would sleep. So we would. So now we take the gates off this time of year so they can just come in here and sleep. Otherwise it would look like this. We normally put shavings down. This helps for the urination. Stuff like that, just to keep it kind of clean. There's our feeding shed. We can just feed mix it, we do ourselves. It's got minerals, it's got corn, crushed corn, it's got alfalfa, it's got some hay, it's got minerals, it's got all the minerals and vitamins we normally use as Ecolab stuff. If you want to look at that, this is what we use for the ewes, this is what we use for the lambs. Here's our feeding schedules, all our data, who's getting what. We get more in depth actually with what we are, how we're feeding them. Kind of looks at a 2 or 3% of the body weight. Here's very important. Very important thing. This is crushed corn with molasses. It's called, well, let's call it chocolate corn. This stuff is high in energy. So yeah, this is kind of what it looks like. Okay, so this is what the stock looks like. This point, yeah, these are small lambs, they're about 3 months old, barely 3 months old. So yeah, that's what they kind of look like compared to the ewes. Here we've got a stuff that we seed every year. It's called Nutri-Feed. It's a type of grass that actually it's got very, very good and nutritious value for the animals. We'll make another video. What is in the feed exactly? And I'm glad I could have shown you guys around. Stay tuned for the next one.